Series Pop Idol just pipped at the post by Will Young. 4 years ago he joined us here on the show, but in those days the conversation had to be pre-recorded because Gareth's stutter was so severe that a live interview was out of the question. He just didn't do them. Even so, Gareth had problems and he struggled to speak. Well, that was then. And when you hear Gareth talking live in a minute, you'll see just how far he's come since that first Pop Idol audition 5 years ago.
Just take your time.
Gareth Gates.
That's fine. When you're ready.
Everybody's looking for that something. Just one thing that makes it all complete. You find it in the strangest places. Places you never knew it could be.
Okay, I'm going to stop you there.
Wow.
Gareth, I'm going to say something. That when you're looking for a star,
yeah,
you take into account everything.
Yeah, yeah, I know.
What you've done today is unbelievably brave, and you are 100% coming to London for the next audition.
Oh, thank you so much.
Yeah.
It's amazing.
Well, Gareth's here now, and in a minute we're going to have a look at his new record. But Gareth, you've been doing this Maguire program now. Yeah. That's what it's called. Is it a breathing technique thing?
Yeah, it's a new way of breathing and a new way of speaking.
Yeah.
And it's fantastic. Now I have the freedom to now speak and say what I want.
It's amazing. Yeah.
It is great.
It's great because you've had a stammer literally since you could first talk, haven't you?
Yeah,
when you're a little baby, little toddler.
Yeah, I mean, and when you're at school with a stammer, well, any problem, you know what kids are like.
Mm.
It was really hard. Looking back now, though, I'm actually quite glad it made me stronger and a better person.
Yeah.
But I'm at the other side of it now, so it's.
I remember you said something like that at some length when we did the pre-recorded interview a few years ago, and we said, in some ways, do you think it's been more a blessing than a curse? And you said, oh yeah, definitely. And you said exactly that even then, even when you were in the middle of it, you were just starting to come out of it then with the program.
Sure.
The thing is, it's worked so well for you. There are occasional pauses and stuff, and you just sort of get your balance back. But it's worked so well that you actually now teach this and coach young kids, don't you?
Yeah.
Brilliant.
I mean, that's an amazing thing. I never thought that I'd be able to speak as fluent as I do now, let alone sort of help other people. That's a real, you know, rewarding feeling. I do like to say that I'm certainly not cured. This is something that I need to continue to work on. The moment that I don't is the, you know, moment that I start to slip back a bit.
You were saying it's a bit, the analogy you gave was, you said it's a little bit like being a sportsman.
Yeah,
the moment
you
stop training and running, you start to lose your fitness. And it's the same thing.
Exercises
every day, that sort of thing?
Yeah. I mean, the more that you do it, the sort of less you have to do and less often. But, if I'm tired or if I've had a few drinks the night before, you know, that's they're the times where it catches me off guard.
This is brilliant. I can't tell you. I mean, we haven't seen you for 3 or 4 years in the flesh. This is brilliant. I'm just loving it. I'm just loving hearing you.
No, I was actually really looking forward to coming on. The last time I was here, I remember I had to have someone from the Maguire.
You did, I remember,
And it was really tense and pre-recording. I was sweating.
We had to keep stopping, didn't we? And they had to keep running on and giving you lessons. Because you're ready to start the programme.
I mean,
presumably, I don't know as much as I should do about stammering, but presumably a lot of it is just psychological. It's fear. There's a great fear in there.
Well, 90% of a stammer is that psychological element. It's the build-up of negative experiences and negative associations.
Right.
And the fear of speaking, the fear of stammering.
Yeah.
And so what we do is we teach a new way of speaking, which handles the physical side of things. But the psychological element is forcing ourselves to do things that we don't want to do, like speaking to new people or handling live interviews.
You can't really get more nerve-wracking than sort of speaking to camera, can you?
No,
live and no retakes and all the rest of it.
I've had lots of practice recently.
Yeah.
I know. You've done
great.
Some very funny interviews of late. Well, look, let's have a look. You've been sort of not out of the loop, but you've been just considering your options and thinking and writing and composing of late.
That's right.
Pictures of the Other Side. Just tell us about it.
Yeah, it's an album. I was working with various different writers. I didn't know what sort of music I wanted to do, and so it was. I just thought I'd experiment.
Yeah.
Lots of different genres, and you know, try out things I'd never tried out before. And I worked with a guy called Mike Tarif. He's responsible for people like James Morrison and Katie Tunstall. And so the record's very much that sort of live based.
Well, I see track number five is New Kid in Town. What, the Eagles song?
No.
That's wondered if it was a cover. No, it's your own.
No, unfortunately not.
Because it is a rather lovely song.
Well, yeah, it's an amazing song.
Well, let's have a look at your single, which is out now from that album. It's called Angel on My Shoulder.
That's right.
There's an angel on my shoulder every night. Make sure that I'm alright. When I'm falling fast, you rescue me. Your love unconditionally. When I'm cold and so alone, back in your arms I feel as well. I pray that you will always be the guardian.
There's an angel on my shoulder.
You always had a beautiful voice, but it's maturing really nicely. It's getting some real depth and you know, increasing power behind it. Do you talk about speech exercises? Do you do singing exercises as well, or do you just busk it?
What I found in the industry, you do sort of more of everything else apart from the music. And you know, when I was a kid growing up, I was so involved in music. Playing lots of different instruments and singing in choirs and bands.
You're classically trained, weren't you?
Yeah. So my instrument practice took up hours and hours of my life every single day. Then when you get into the music industry, all of a sudden you're doing very little music. And it's all about. I mean, I know that it is about interviews and all that as well. But you end up doing more of that than actual music. So my voice is just sort of being left by the wayside, but you know, I'm getting older and more mature, so.
Well, it's easy to forget that you're only 17.
I was.
Idol, you know, and you're only, what, 22 now?
I am, yeah.
You lucky thing.
I know. it's all good.
Good luck with the album, it's all good, you're sounding great, and Angel on My Shoulders is out now, and Gareth's album, Pictures of the Other Side, is out on Monday.
That's right.
We'll see you tomorrow.
See you tomorrow, bye.